Here are some apples. They're green ones, sweet ones, ripe, in season. Just, you know, apples. No real differences between them, except, well, they don't all have the exact same figure. This one is a little bigger. Some have spots, are a different colour. And then inside, you soon discover the seeds don't have the same positions. The cores not always of equal thickness. And whilst they're the same, you have to admit that each apple is also very different. And this sameness, mixed with differences, is in a massive list of things. It's in lemons, melons, loads of fruit, and milkshakes too, and bowls of soup. It's in bread from the bakers, month-old trainers, alligators, mashed potatoes, celebrity impersonators. It's in craters, moons, tailored suits, each hug your mother gave to you, each pancake, each handshake, each grass snake, each landscape, each gap and each strand that makes up each snowflake. And there's no way you'll find a snowflake like another that's formed, yet each snowflake's as much a snowflake as each snowflake that falls. And sometimes we like to try and cut differences out in production lines, and I guess that's fine for cogs and screws and scaffolding pipes or bricks or tins or microchips, but there's no point in trying to fit a person into a mould like that. I just don't think we're made for it. We might have the same components, but we're going to be frustrated if we focus on our magazines, on models out on catwalks. We're not meant to be production line. We're much more like an apple. From our skin down to our core, we're a snowflake. It's so strange and stunning how we're formed. We each receive a body that is different and unique. Yet each person's as much a person as each person you'll meet.